Hello guys, Sajid is here with a new video, and in this video we will talk about Laravel Envoy. Laravel Envoy is actually an official Laravel package and is used to run command easily against our development or production server. Currently Envoy only supports the Mac and Linux operating system. It doesn't support the Windows operating system. So let's start by installing it. This is the command to install the Laravel Envoy. The latest version of this package is 1.6. So I copy this command and open the terminal. Here I paste the command and run it. I already installed it, that's why it says nothing to install or update. Now I check that the Envoy is available in my terminal or not. It says command not found. So I need to run this command. I copy it and paste it here. Now I try again, and now Envoy is available for me, and the current version is Laravel Envoy 1.6.1. This is the current version, 1.6.1. I'm working on this project in my company, and during work I run different commands. I run git commands to stage the files and folders, to commit the changes, to push and pull the code. I use composer command to install, uninstall or update the dependencies. I use artisan command to migrate the migrations, to seed the seeders, and to run the local development server. Let's simplify our work by using Envoy. First step is to create this file envoy.blade.php in the root of our project. I copy this name, go to my project and create this file here. In the top of this file, we define our servers. In my case, I have only one server. I call it local, and the address of my server is 127.0.127.0.0.1. This is the address of my server. The next step is to define our task. I copy this command, paste it here. I will call setup. My task name is setup, and I want to run against my local server. I want to run this task against my local server, and the command inside this task is php artisan migrate. So this command will migrate my migrations. Now I run this task. This task name is setup. So the command is envoy run, then the name of your task. My task name is setup. And in this task, we have only one command, which is php artisan server. And this command will run against our local server. As you can see, I run this task and my migrations are migrating. As you can see, all migrations are migrated. Now let's talk about stories. In story, we grip our task, and in each task we have command. I also copy these two tasks and I define them here. I call it migrations. Okay, now I want to group these three tasks in a story. So this is the syntax. We have git. Now here we list the name of the task. This task name is git, Then we have composer. Then we have migration. So I format this. Okay, so this is our story, and in this story we have three tasks, and in each task we have a command. Now I run this story. So how I can run? I will write envoy run, then the name of the task or the name of the story. So now I enter the name of the story. It is asking about the password. The first command is git. That's why it's asking about the password, the git password. Now, okay, so already up to date, this is our git, this command, this task. These lines are from this task, composer task. And this line, nothing to migrate, is from this task. So through one command I can run three commands. Through this Laravel, through this command envoy run deploy, I can run three tasks, and in each task I have one command. I can list here many tasks. I'm also working on another project with another US developer. So this is our envoy.blade.php file. We have one server local, and we have one story local, and we have one task local build, and in task we have these commands. Now let's use variable in our envoy file. So here the branch is variable. Now I run this command, and deploy is my story name, and I'm also passing a branch variable. I'm also passing a variable value master. Master is the value of my branch variable. So, and I'm using branch here. It's asking again for the password. We can also define variables in our envoy.blade.php file. So here I create another section. Sorry, I copy this and paste it here. I create a variable, I call it branch, and this is equal to master. Now I don't need to pass this variable in the command. Again, my code is working fine, and the git is asking for password. We can also use multiple servers, and we can pass it into our task. So this means we can run a task against multiple servers. You can enable parallel execution against multiple servers. You can send notifications through envoy to Slack. You can also send notification through envoy to Discord. Discord is another application like Slack. So thank you for watching this video. If there is any question, you can ask me on Slack. Thank you, bye.